No. The push to explore for oil in Collier County is expanding tonight. A meeting is underway talking about an oil company's proposal to survey more than 100 miles straddling Alligator Alley in the Big Cypress Preserve. NBC2's Brian Anderson joins us now with a breakdown of what they want to do. Brian.
Kelly, Big Cypress officials tell me oil exploration is allowed in the National Preserve. Tonight's meeting focused on three different ways it can get started.
A pristine 110 square miles of land in the Big Cypress Preserve. It's not what's on top, but what's underneath this land that interests Burnett Oil Company.
You create a fake earthquake with some sort of instrument.
FGCU geology professor Dr. James McDonald explains how a seismic survey could tell if there's oil underground.
As you're moving through rock that has water in it, you're going to have a certain density, so it'll have a certain velocity. If you're moving through rock that maybe has oil in it, the density will change.
There are two different ways of going about it. One is to use big trucks with metal plates called vibrosize buggies.
They send waves down into the ground.
The sound waves bounce off the underground terrain, sending the information back to receivers so scientists can tell what's below. This would take up to a full dry season. Option two calls for underground explosions. Each site would contain up to 7.5 pounds of explosives, 100 to 200 feet below the surface.
It sounds very dramatic because it has the word explosive in it. So you might think, oh my gosh, they're going to set off a large explosive and create an earthquake, but it's not. It's very small explosive.
He compares it to a gunshot into the ground, a plan that could take up to two dry seasons. The final option is not to allow the company to do the survey.
Tonight's meeting is happening right now until 7 in Ochoapi. The National Park Service is accepting comments until December 20th. To weigh in, there's a link on our website, nbc-2.com. Click on this story. In the newsroom, Brian Anderson, NBC2.